Hello everyone, I am Bilge Kan, and today we will discuss a momentum question. This is the conservative system, an example of conservative systems. So, in the question, it's given as to there is no friction between the air and this canoe movement and also the water with this canoe. So, the question asks us, this movement starts 1 meter ahead of the start and moves 3 meters to the end of the canoe. And the canoe total length is 5 meters, and it asks us how much canoe will be moved behind to this system movement. So there isn't any velocity is given, and we can see since this system is conservative, delta momentum, so difference of the momentum is equal to zero. Now, how can we solve this question? Actually, if it's given the velocity of the woman and the canoe, we can find it again, but it shouldn't be necessary, and also it will be, you know, too much challenging for us. So we can use a concept that since this system is conservative from the external forces, the center of mass of the system is stable in here. So let's see how we will solve this question. Let's call this an axis, and there is origin, start of the canoe. Now I can find the center of mass of this system. So moment's mass 45 times the distance from the origin 1 plus canoe's mass 60 kg, and since the canoe is uniform, its center of mass in middle of the canoe, so it's 2.5 meters.
Use this notation too.
Over total mass, which is 105. So this should be equal to the last system, last situation of the system. So the woman moves here, and let's visualize this thing again. Let's say this is origin, and canoe moves a bit behind, and the woman sits in here, 1 meter of behind of the end. So I can call this distance as x. I don't know. I will find it. And the center of mass this canoe is how much away from the origin. So if I call this distance x, I know it's here. So this is 2.5 meter ahead, and this is the 1.5 meter ahead. This is here 4 meters, so this is the 1.5 meter of ahead. So if I call this distance x, so this distance becomes x minus 1.5. But in the question, how much this canoe will slide behind to is asking, and therefore I can call this x, and I can call this distance as x plus 1.5. So I can calculate new center of mass of this system as x times canoe's mass. Actually, this is not our axis, so I can show it by multiplication symbol. X times 60 plus x plus 1.5 times 45 over total mass 105. So these are cancels each other, and I obtain in here 120, 105, and 50. So 995 I obtain in here center of mass for, and also the in here I can get 105x plus 45 times 1.5, 45. And also I can say, 135 over 2. So when I multiply this by 2, I obtain 390 over 2. So when I subtract it from this, I obtain 1255 over 2 over 105 equals x. Now I can divide these things by 5. And also, I can divide these things by 15. So when I divide this by 15, I obtain 7. And when I divide this by 15, I obtain 1 and 17. So the result is 17 over 14 meter. This is the Carnot's new center of mass. So for the how much Carnot moves away, I should calculate delta x, which is equal to the actually yes final position 17 over 14 minus initial position, which is 2.5, and I can calculate it by 25 over 10, let's say. So multiply this 7 and expand this by 7 and expand this by 5, I obtain 585 and minus 514 17, yes, 175, is it correct? Yes, over 17. So I obtain in here minus 19 over 17. Yes, let's look. Yes, so the total displacement is minus 9 over 7 meters for this canoe. So thank you for listening, and I hope this question will be beneficial for you.